Hi everyone, it's time for another dev news since we've released the 14.2 version of OCCT. The main change is a 3D adaptive test which switched from DirectX to Vulkan under Windows. And why did we do that? Let's find out. All right, be warned, this is going to get a tad technical. So before in 14.1, we had 3D Adaptive using DirectX, we had VRAM using OpenCL, and under Linux, we had 3D Adaptive using Vulkan, and VRAM also using OpenCL. The first thing is we were forced to maintain a DirectX version and a Vulkan version. So the first goal of this move is having us maintain only one version, which is a Vulkan one, which is a more modern one. And the main thing about Vulkan is that it has a much more modern device detection algorithm. In DirectX, we are forced to use DXGI, which is pretty limited. We can, but it's not obvious, identify if a GPU is a discrete one, an integrated one, and it's very tough in DirectX to actually link a particular device with a device in OpenCL. That link isn't obvious. Under Windows, this posed not a lot of problem until now because once you install the driver, you've got automatically DirectX, Vulkan, OpenCL support at the same time, one shot. Under Linux, it was different. You may have Vulkan support, but you've got some additional packages to enable OpenCL. So this was starting to make a mess on the Linux side. So we wanted to streamline that. And by doing so, we had to implement a link between Vulkan and OpenCL devices, which is feasible. Not easy, but feasible. Surprisingly, and this is a pun, and this is very intended, it's much easier on NVIDIA cards because they are giving us a unique identifier per device, while on AMD drivers, you have to rely on the PCIe address, which is much, much less easy and less obvious to do so. Anyway, we got it down, we could link both devices. And to streamline that, we switched to Vulkan and implemented the very same algorithm under Windows. So now we've got a unified architecture. Performance seems to be a tad in favor of Vulkan, and overall, the developer experience and testing shows it's as reliable and even more reliable. We also had some issues with Unreal Engine in its DirectX pipeline, which we don't have in Vulkan, so that actually fixed some bugs which were lingering in 14.1. So overall, it's a very beneficial move for everyone. We've already reached the end of this dev news, which is pretty short, but 14.2 is an intermediate release for v15, which is scheduled in August, which will bring the storage stress test and even more stuff. We are also working on the O-ring driver, which is due by the end of this summer, maybe it's September, but it's very close by. We are taking much longer than expected, but we're in the kernel environment and we cannot afford to take any chances here. As usual, like, subscribe, and now that you can, if you like the software, drop us a good review on Steam, please. Thank you!